Welcome to Educare 247 guys. So today we are going to kickstart a new CAT Concept Express series for you. So this is a new series that I'm starting for you guys, which will cover all the unique and important concepts under CAT that you ultimately require to solve questions in CAT. Without these concepts, you will not be in a position to solve these questions. And these are the concepts that are often repeated in your CAT, ZAT and all the important MBA entrance examinations, especially CAT. So we have handpicked it, we have done the research, we have worked hard on the examples that we're going to take over here, and this is definitely going to make a difference in your score that you're going to get. So I request you to go through this complete video and solve the examples that I'm going to take at the end of it. It will be very helpful to you and very fruitful, trust me. Also, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon if you want to be updated every time a video is uploaded. And you guys are updated with the latest videos that I'll be putting up. Alright, so let's get started with this chicken McNugget theorem. So today we are going to see this chicken McNugget theorem. Alright, or it is also known as postage stamp problem. Alright, postage stamp theorem. Alright, vegetarians might call it postage stamp theorem and non-vegetarians might call it chicken McNugget. But this is purely known as chicken McNugget theorem. Alright, so let's get started with this theorem, try to understand what this is, and then we'll delve into some examples on it. So this chicken McNugget theorem is an extremely interesting concept which has extremely specific applications. Alright, the question type asks you to find the largest number which cannot be formed using two or three denominations. Let's see how we can solve it. Alright, so the theorem states, if A and B are two coprime numbers, then the largest number which cannot be formed or written in the form of ax plus by is a into b minus a minus b. Alright, I'll explain you what this means. The story behind this concept is pretty much interesting. So once in McDonald's, chicken nuggets used to be available in denominations of 9 and 20. Alright, so once a person wondered what would be the largest number of nuggets one could not have even if any combination of two denominations were used. So using this, what was the largest number of nuggets that could not have been formed? Alright, so the answer was tested by heat and trial method and it came out to be 151. Alright, so mathematically the answer can be found out using this formula. Alright, so I'll give you an example. Suppose 2 and 5 are the two coprime numbers. Alright, you have coins of 2 rupees and you have a coin of 5 rupees. Alright, denominations of 2 and 5, rupees 2 and rupees 5. Alright, their HCF is 1, that is why they are coprime. Right, so first condition is satisfied that their two numbers are coprime. Alright, then we need to find out which is the largest sum that cannot be formed using the denominations of 2 and 5. So, purely, your answer will be 2 into 5 minus 2 minus 5. Alright, so this will be 10 minus 2 minus 5, which will be 3. Alright, so this is the largest number which cannot be formed using the denominations of 2 and 5. Alright, so if you cross check, after 3 there is 4. Alright, so can you form 4 with the help of 2 and 5? Yes, 2 into 2 plus 5 into 0. Alright, so using 2 rupees, 2 coins, you can form 4. Can you form 5 with the help of 2 and 5? Yes, you can. 2 into 0 plus 5 into 1. Right, can you form 6? Yes, you can form 6 also. So basically 2 into 3 plus 5 into 0. So you see, each and every sum after 3 can be formed using 2 and 5. So this is what this concept means. The largest number which cannot be formed using two coprime numbers. The formula is this, given over here. A into B minus A minus B. A simplistic formula. Now, further, if you want to find out how many such sums or number exist that cannot be expressed in terms of AX plus BY, that is the sum, alright, is A minus 1 into B minus 1 divided by 2. So, in the previous case, alright, we had taken a case of 2 and 5. We had denominations of rupees 2 and rupees 5. Alright. So, how many such numbers or sums are there which cannot be formed using 2 and 5? So, basically, 2 minus 1 into 5 minus 1 divided by 2, which is equals to 1 into 4 divided by 2 is equals to 2, right? So, there are two such numbers. What are those numbers? And it is 1 and 3, because 3 was the greatest number, right? Largest number which cannot be expressed in the form of ax plus b. Alright, the other number is 1. So there are a total of 2 numbers. So I hope you have understood this. It is very simple. Just the application of formula is needed and you would have understood by now. The formula is also very simple. But if you do not know this formula, it will become very difficult for you to do the hit and trial method. And you will just keep on doing it in the exam and end up wasting 10 to 15 minutes. If you are not aware about this concept and the formula. Let us now have a look at the questions, alright, the application to the problem solving. The question says, what is the largest denomination that cannot be formed? Alright, cannot be formed, please note over here. By using two types of coins of rupees 7 and rupees 5, alright. So we know the formula for this, just apply the chicken McNugget or postage stamp theorem. A into B minus A minus B. Here, A is equals to 7, B is equals to 5, right? So 7 into 5. Minus 7 minus 5, right? So 35 minus 12. All right, what is 35 minus 12? It is 23. Hence 23 is the largest sum that cannot be formed using the denominations of rupees 7 and rupees 5. As simple as that. And you can check it out. 23 we cannot form. 7 threes is 21, but we cannot accommodate 5 over here, right? If you take 24, all right, you can take 7 into 2 plus 5 into 2, right? So this can be expressed in the form of ax plus by, but this cannot be. Hence, your correct answer over here is 23. I hope you are getting the point now. You're getting the concept. So I hope, guys, you understood the concept of chicken McNugget theorem and you enjoyed it. If you did, please like the video and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos in this series. Thank you and happy learning.